After hearing about the challenges that many players in the Swedish society faces when it comes to fishing tourism development, we will now make another international outlook at the popular destination's success factors. Welcome to the stage, Johan David Snorrason from Iceland's biggest fishing tourism company, Angling Club Laxå.
Your Majesty, Governor, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna start this. So, I'm gonna... Jag pratar lite svenska, men jag är bättre till engelska, så jag ska ha den här föredrag på engelska. So, I'm going to speak to you about fishing tourism success factors in Iceland, as I see them. My name is Johan David Snorrason. I'm the marketing and sales manager of the company Laxå Angling Club in Iceland. Oh, this is me. I happen to work with what I love, which is always a blessing in life. This is actually taken in Russia, so it's a little cheating. Now, here. Laxå Angling Club was founded in 1987. And so it's one of the oldest players in the market in Iceland, and it's the largest outfitter in Iceland with over 30 employees in the summertime. We lease over 20 rivers and beats, which when we sell on then. I will talk to you better about that later. What I'm going to talk about is how to create a high-end product in the fishing industry, what we've been doing in Iceland. I will talk you through those points then. The Icelandic laws environment is the foundation that gives us exclusivity, which gives us privacy and higher catch returns. We have professionalism, high-class service, and catch and release. The Icelandic law model, the laws are dating back to the time of the settlement. The first reference of the laws is in the Grágás, which is one of the oldest legal books in the world, I believe. Dated 1932. It says in that book, hver maður á að veiða fugla og fiska í sínu landi, which means each man has the right to fish and hunt in his own land, and only him. Current laws are with amendments number 61 from 2006. The Icelandic law model is like this, rivers and lakes, most of them are privately owned in Iceland, around 95%, I would say. It is mandatory by law to form a river organization of each river, so all the owners must come together and form an organization of their river. And then they have a valuable product within their hands, and so they put the rights to the fishing of the river up for auction. So they can get the best price for the fishing rights in the river. Usually the highest bidder gets the rights to the river and the contract is around 3 to 5 years at a time. So the outfitter has time to market and promote the river because he knows exactly how long time he will have the rights to the fishing in the river. And the farmers and landowners, they get lease revenue from the river. And it's very important to many farmers in Iceland, especially in rural areas, because they get much of their income maybe from the river that flows through the land. And they could not be farming in some instances if they didn't get the money from the river. This is the Icelandic river structure. You have the river, then you have the landowners organization, and then you have the outfitter, which is me. And then I create the product and I sell it on to clients. Sometimes the landowners organization, they skip the outfitter part and sell it directly themselves. But it's difficult for them, so it's very few of them do it like that. With an outfitter, I think, is around 90% of the rivers in Iceland. exclusivity, privacy, and high catch returns. The system in Iceland allows very few rods in each river, and exclusive rights to fish. Remote location, and that gives us high amount of salmon caught per each rod. Maybe you have in Iceland, you have a river that's 15 kilometers long, but we only allow 4 rods. So you have 4 kilometers of fishing only for your rod. And that is, I've learned from my clients that this is what they're most interested in, privacy. Fishing is one of the things, but what they value the most is the privacy and being alone, being somewhere calm and alone. You know, they maybe come from high-stress environments like London and New York or Moscow or something, and they just want to be somewhere where they can be alone. So, this is not what I am selling. I can't sell that. This is what I'm selling. I can't sell that. This is what I'm selling. And this. This is the River Norðurá, one of the most beautiful in the world, in my opinion. So, professionalism and high-class service and catch and release, we have excellent guides. And in many instances, the guides, they are brought up in a farm close to the river. So they know the river like the palm of their hands, and the river gives them jobs and gives the farmer money as well. So it's a win-win situation in that respect. You have to have good guides. We have high-class lodges in many rivers with full service. It's like staying in a four-star hotel with a nice restaurant, everything inclusive. We are 100% follow-through with service, so everything has to be perfect because I always have high-end clients, so I enable high-end service all the time. Catch and release, that's really important. Most of my clients are from America, the United Kingdom, and they only want river, some of them, with catch and release. They don't want to see a dead salmon ever. It would be sustainable in most rivers in Iceland to kill a few salmon, but still we won't allow it. And because the clients do not like it at all. And also a factor for that is if you kill a salmon, you won't catch it again. We have studied this. We've marked the salmon we release, and sometimes we catch it 5 times in one season. So one salmon is caught 5 times. So it makes the fish much more valuable because there's better fishing in the river overall. Because you have more fish swimming and fewer of them dead on the bank. So we have a very high customer retention rate. Most of my clients, they come up again, again, and again, year after year. So this is the old days in Iceland. I cannot post this on my Facebook pages anymore. I would lose all my following there. This is how we do it today. This is similar. Too much blood. This is how we do it today. You can see the salmon is alive and he's going to be released back into the river. the operation structure in Iceland, fishing is allowed in those times between 7 and 1 and from 3 to 9 in the evening. Only in this time. It's only 12 hours per day that's allowed. Fishing is allowed for 90 days per annum in the salmon rivers. And the lakes and the sea trout rivers are open from April until October. And fishing is usually from noon to noon. That is, you start fishing at noon and then you end at noon, which is most convenient for usually for the clients because then they can start fishing in the same day they fly over sometime. we have larger rivers with full service lodges. And then we have smaller rivers, most of with self-catering lodges. And then we have day trips and license only. I'm going to talk to you about our self-catering rivers, how that works. They are inclusive of a license and self-catering accommodation. There are rivers and beaches from 2 to 4 rods. And you must rent a car and bring your own food and prepare your own food. You must do everything. We just provide the accommodation and the license. We have 12 rivers and beaches with self-catering accommodation. And I'm going to show you an example of a self-catering river. It's the Stora Laxá Beat 4, which is absolutely a stunning beat. You should go there sometime if you can. it has 4 rods, a nice lodge with 5 bedrooms, barbecue and a jacuzzi and a working kitchen and everything. So it's very good for a group of friends or a large family that just want to be private and can handle cooking and doing everything for themselves. This is Stora Laxá Beat 4. Then we have the full service rivers. They are inclusive of license, full service lodge, full board and luxury accommodation. Inclusive in the package is usually a guide shared with another road and return transfers from Reykjavik. So this is an all-inclusive package. You just have to buy the airplane ticket to Iceland and we take care of the rest. This is a very popular option with many of my clients. This is the Eastern Angá, full service river. Nice salmon from there. It was number two in Iceland in 2018 with almost 4,000 salmon caught, and that's 5 salmon per rod per day in prime time, which is considered very good fishing for Atlantic salmon. Then we offer trout fishing. This is from Lake Þingvallavatn, and this is the trophy brown trout, which is very popular. Lake Þingvallavatn, it has a public beat, but then it also has private beats. And the public beat, you can just go and buy a license for all the Icelanders, or just everybody that wants to buy. It's very cheap. But then we have private beats, which are better for the big brown trout. And then you have only 2 to 4 rods, and the licenses there are more expensive. So that's an example of how it's mixed with private and common beats in one area. We have the Tungufljót brown trout, the lax on Mývasveit, which is some of the best brown trout in the world. And we offer both day trips, license only, and with self-catering accommodation. It's a beautiful fish. So the results, the total annual revenue of the fishing tourism is 664 million in 2018. Actually, this is a brand new report just out. It doesn't look like that a high of number if you compare it to Sweden, but we are only 350,000 in Iceland. So in relation to that, it's a lot. And it's up from 129 million in 2004, which is a 160% increase in 14 years, which is very good result, I would say. And the owners get each year 228 million. And the total worth of the fishing right, if it would be sold as a whole, is 5.5 billion Swedish kronas. It's quite valuable if you have a land to a good salmon river in Iceland. There are thousands of farmers that depend on the income, as I told you. And there are over 60 companies that work directly with fishing tourism and thousands of high-skilled jobs. And the fishing tourist is a very valuable tourist because he spends a lot. They are in the top bracket of the tourists, which are very, very valuable. Yeah, that's it. That's me again. Thank you.